Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can add elements of 1D array in Java. So first of all, I am going to import a package whose name is util. Inside this package, a class is available, that is scanner. This scanner class is used to read values from user. Now I am going to define a class whose name is ArraySum. Inside this class, I am going to implement definition of main method. Inside this main method, I will be writing the code which will read elements from user, and those elements will be stored in 1D array, and then I have to print some of those elements with the help of Java program. So first of all, I am going to declare an array, variable n, variable s, and variable I. For sum, I have used s variable, which is initialized with 0. Now I am going to create instance of this scanner class, that is input. So this input will be used to read values from user, and system.in will decide that the input will be received from console. Now here you can see I have just declared an array. I have not created memory blocks for this array. So before creating memory, I have to read size of array from user. So with the message enter size of array, user will be entering size of array. So that will be received through this method nextInt, and the value will be stored inside n variable. So in this program, user is deciding how many elements user want to store inside the array. So that size will be decided by this n variable. Now after reading size, I can create memory blocks for the array. So you can see line number 11. This line number 11 is creating n memory blocks for array ARR. Now I am going to receive elements from user. So I am writing a loop which is starting from 0. Its termination condition is I less than ARR dot length. This length is an attribute of array which provides size of the array automatically. Now to read values, again I am using input dot nextInt method. So input dot nextInt will be receiving values one by one, and the values will be stored inside ARR. So line number 15 will receive elements from user, and this loop will repeat n times. So total n elements will be received, and their values will be stored inside the array. Now I have to calculate their sum. So just after reading the value, I can add that into s variable. So line number 16 will add all the elements provided by the user into s. So here two operations are performing. The entered element is storing in the array, and as well as its addition is storing into s variable. Now after completion of this loop, I can print the sum on output screen. With line number 18, sum of array will be displayed on output screen. So this way I have implemented the complete code in front of you, which will receive n numbers from user, and sum of those numbers will be printed on output screen with the help of 1D array in Java. Now I have saved this code with Ctrl plus S. You can see name of file, which is ArraySum. It is saved in D drive inside Java folder. So for compilation and execution, I am going to open command prompt. You can see I have moved to C drive and Java folder. After moving to specific location, I have to compile the code. For that purpose, I have used the command javac arraysum.java. So here I have implemented that statement and it is not showing any error. It means source code is written correctly. Now we can execute our code. For execution, I have typed java arraysum. So just after execution, code will ask size of array. So I have entered size as 5. After entering size, it will ask for elements. So I have entered 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after complete input, automatically sum of all the elements will be displayed. So you can see code is showing sum equals to 15, which is sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. So this time I have entered 5. Again, I am going to execute the code and I am entering size as 10. So this time it is asking for 10 elements. So I am entering 10 times 1. You can see the output. It is showing sum equals to 10. So it means this array is working dynamically. Whatever size of element you want to enter in the array, you can do with the help of this program. So in case of Java, array works dynamically, but in case of C and C++, array can work statically or dynamically in both the ways. But in case of Java, you can directly use array in form of dynamic. So the benefit of dynamic array is that you can provide size of array at execution time, and as per the size you can enter the elements for processing. So I hope you have understood how we can use 1D array in Java to print some of the elements. If you want to follow me, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.